Let's see the second part of surface chemistry. Already we have discussed the first part, adsorption, that's over. Second part is catalysis. Here cata means wholly, that means completely. Lysis means to decompose. Lysis means to decompose or to loss. That means all the reactants are decomposed to products using a particular substance. So that's why catalysis, that means catalysis, wholly to decompose. The word catalysis was introduced by, the word was introduced by Berzelius. What is the definition for catalyst? And after that, what is the catalysis? So what is catalyst? A substance which alters, that means changes, the rate of a chemical reaction to which it is added. A substance which alters the rate of a chemical reaction to which it is added without itself consuming in the reaction, without itself being consumed in the reaction. That means it does not disappear in the reaction, does not consume in the reaction, but it changes the rate of a reaction. So what is the definition for catalyst? Catalyst is a substance, catalyst is a substance which changes the rate of a, which changes the rate of a chemical reaction without itself being consumed in the reaction. That is the definition for catalyst. And the process in which the catalyst is usually said to be catalysis. A substance which is used to change the rate of reaction is called catalyst, and the process in which catalyst is used called catalysis. Catalysis is of two types, positive catalysis, negative catalysis. So catalyst is also two types, positive catalyst, other one negative catalyst. Let's see what is positive catalyst. You know, positive catalyst means which increases the rate of reaction, which increases the rate of reaction when it is added is called positive catalyst. And the process of adding a positive catalyst is called positive catalysis. Okay. Similarly, what is negative catalyst? Negative catalyst, it simply decreases, a negative catalyst decreases the rate of a chemical reaction. We can explain the role of catalyst using potential energy diagrams. See, for positive catalysis and negative catalysis, the potential energy diagrams are, along y-axis we take potential energy, along x-axis reaction coordinate, that means progress of the reaction, reaction coordinate, progress of the reaction. Suppose A is the reactant, B is the product. In the conversion from A to B, if we use a catalyst, what is its role? So for that, have a look on this potential diagram. Without catalyst, see, this is the path followed by the reactants to give the products. Suppose the given reaction is exothermic, then it is the graph. Okay. So here, without catalyst, this is the path. With positive catalyst, what happens? Rate of reaction increases. So you know, this is the energy of reactant. This is the energy of product. The difference between these two is called enthalpy of reaction, delta H. You know, this is called activational energy, sorry, threshold energy. This gap is called activational energy, EA. EA means what? Activational energy. Without catalyst, EA is activational energy. If a catalyst is added, which catalyst? If a positive catalyst is added, what is its effect on the path of this reaction? See, here I am drawing a dotted line path. So this is the path, this thick line. Thick line indicates without catalyst, path of reaction. Dotted line indicates in the presence of positive catalyst, path of reaction. So here thick line without catalyst, the dotted line with positive catalyst. What is that? Positive catalyst. Okay. So here, what is activational energy in this case? This is activational energy EA dash. What is EA dash? Activational energy in the presence of positive catalyst. EA means activational energy in the absence of catalyst. Which is more? Which is more, EA or EA dash? Yes, EA is more. EA is greater than EA dash, where EA dash is activational energy in the presence of positive catalyst. EA means in the absence of catalyst. How rate and activational energy is related? Rate of reaction is inversely proportional to activational energy. Rate of reaction is inversely proportional to activational energy. So as there is decrease in the activational energy, with a positive catalyst, there is increase in the rate of reaction. So positive catalyst increases the rate of reaction by setting a new path of lower activational energy. So how does a positive catalyst increase the rate of reaction? Just say that a catalyst added makes the reaction to follow in a new path of lower activational energy. Got it? If a negative catalyst is added, what happens? Negative catalyst is added. Then see, if a negative catalyst added, then this path is followed. So this is the path with the negative catalyst. That means here activational energy is further increased. That means rate of reaction further decreases. Okay. So what happened with positive and negative catalyst? When a positive catalyst is added, rate of reaction increases due to the decrease in its activational energy. But when a negative catalyst is added, rate of reaction decreases due to increase in the activational energy. Because activational energy and rate of reaction are inversely proportional to each other. So that's why a positive catalyst increases the rate of reaction and a negative catalyst decreases the rate of reaction. Okay. So by the addition of either a positive or a negative catalyst, there is no change in the energy of reactant, no change in the energy of product, no change in the enthalpy of reaction, delta H also. So an important objective question it is, which of the following changes by the addition of a positive catalyst or negative catalyst? Options: energy of reactants, first option. Second option, energy of products. Third option, enthalpy of reaction. Fourth option, activational energy. What is the question? which of the following changes by the addition of a positive or negative catalyst? So which factor changes? Energy of reactant or product, enthalpy of reaction, or activational energy? Which changes? Yes, activational energy is only changing with the presence of either positive or negative catalyst. Okay, no change in the energy of reactant, no change in the energy of product, and no change in the enthalpy of reaction. Okay, there is change in activational energy and threshold energy. Threshold energy is also changing. Threshold energy means it is the minimum energy. It is the minimum energy reactant molecules must reach to give the products. Okay. So this is potential energy diagram to explain the working of a catalyst. Now let's see some examples for positive catalysis and negative catalysis.